And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Hello, there he is.
This is what you wanted.
Hello.
And this is what you...
Hello.
It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J. Oakerson, and this is the motherfucking Lost Tapes. Great week of shows. We've had such great fun. Snowstorm hit.
Don't you hate when people ask you a question that you don't have a good answer to? Somebody said on Twitter, like, I don't understand, why is it called The Lost Tapes?
Because like, we fucking felt like calling it that.
Man.
What do you want to call it?
Is it cooler title than the pre-record day?
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Pre-Record Thursdays.
Makes you feel like you're part of something.
Yeah.
Oh, Lost Tapes. Only I know about this.
These are the B-sides, motherfuckers.
Yeah, this is the rarity. This
switch
is the
it to
only
Jenny
the fans listen.
Switch it to Jenny McCarthy if you want to hear some fucking...
Oh my god. Something, something.
Boogers
vagina.
Are funny. Boogers
and
are
delicious. She, remember that? Yeah. Everything she did was like hot, gross.
Hot, it was like hot girl doing a gross thing.
Yeah. A lot of like fake farts.
And then Chris Hardwick was just like, bitch, let me make my billions.
Yeah. Oh man, he was on his way.
Oh dude, that guy's got tech money now. Oh,
could you imagine if he just like, just pumped the brakes for 1 second and tried to hook up with Jenny McCarthy? He wasn't, no, he's all biz.
Dude, he was all biz, but that's why he's smart.
Do you think Chris Hardwick just crushes crazy pussy?
I think he's like married now.
Is he?
He married a Californian princess, the Hertz family.
From the Hertz rental car?
Hertz castle.
He married the more money?
Let's get back to rental cars, guys. I'm a rental car fan. Hertz rental car?
No, H-E-R-S-T, I believe.
Oh, like Hertz. No, H-E-A-R-S-T.
Like yes. Willie, like...
Garrison Hertz.
Garrison. No, Garrison Hertz was the running back for the 49ers.
Yeah. Not well. William, William Garrison Hurst.
William Garrison Hurst. Wait, is it William Garrison Hurst? Because Garrison, you guys are fucking me up now, because Garrison Hurst was legitimately the running back for the 49ers.
William Randolph Garrison Hurst.
He was the publishing. Garrison Hurst. He was the publishing error. He was the one that Citizen Kane's based off of.
He had a pretty great four, I think a 4.440.
Yeah. Oh, dude, he was trouble out of the backfield. He could catch and run.
William Randolph Garrison Hurst.
That Sunday, other papers learned.
Lydia Hurst is his wife. Let me take a peek.
Oh, dude, they have so much money between them.
Yeah.
Yo, Chris Hardwick eating good.
I bet he was crushing it before that.
Oh, yeah, dude. There were so many hot skater girls. He banged so many hot Avril Lavigne-looking girls.
He has a drawer full of tiny ties, tiny neckties.
He's got a half ramp. He's got a half pipe in his backyard.
Take me anywhere. Take me somewhere.
Why am I steaming up?
He's plowed out to that song a lot.
Yeah. What's
take
this? What song
take
is this?
Me somewhere.
Complicated.
Oh, this is a good one. She's got a few that I think are all right.
What do you like?
This is a good one.
What's your poison?
Why, you like a lot, Lou? Lou's an Avril Lavigne fan under the radar?
Dude, is that your secret?
Did they open for PJ once?
She does have a lot of angst.
She does. She's super angsty.
Do you really go home? Do you like hold a pillow to your face and scream into it while the song plays? This was his initial instinct to go by this one. I went with the slow.
And then he has the fake argument in the shower where he's like, Don Wicklund comes in and he's all like, hey Lou, I heard about it. I didn't eat pizza over the board. I don't eat pizza over the board. I care.
What's the song called, Christine? You know. You love 14-year-old girl rock.
No,
take me somewhere.
Girlfriend.
I don't, no, that's Fast Song.
She's married to Chad Kroeger from Nickelback,
she,
right?
She was. She was with the guy from,
Sum 41.
Derek Whibtily. It's too many vowels in a row. Derek Whibtily.
We're getting off Chris Hardwick banging all this fucking angsty skater puss.
Oh, no, we did. We jumped into Avril Lavigne from Skater Puss. I can show you the track.
You want to follow this?
I can show you the tracks we took.
You're like an old tracker in the West. You know, the tracks are soft. We are just talking about Skater
it's
Puss.
It's a cold damn night.
Oh, that's later in Lavigne. I know what you're talking about.
Take me by the hand, take me somewhere. Christine, get out of Chris Hardwick. He's already married. Please stop looking at pictures of Chris Hardwick.
Stop comparing him
to his wife's money. And please, for the love of God, look up these lyrics. It's a cold damn night.
The best part about Lost Tapes is the people listening to this are like, I know the answer.
I'm with you.
But you don't realize that we're through our Terminator timeline. We're back on Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
So we're in the past. So get over it.
So even though you're screaming the name in your car.
Yeah.
You angsty little campers.
It's I'm with you. How does Jay not know this?
Just a girl wearing like a red and black striped sock on her hand.
No, getting ready for a shift at the bees. Punching the steering wheel before a waiting table shift. I'm all too familiar with it.
This, man. Oh, I bet you can plug up some JNCO jeans box to this.
Yeah. This is definitely the song that you put on as a girl's removing a wife beater that covers up some scars from cutting.
Oh. I feel like my first girlfriend ever would have dug this, like, Avril Lavigne. I think she did.
I feel like I would have dug this when I was, like, 15. Oh. I dig this at 34. Fuck off.
I only dig it at 34. Crank it, Lou.
Yeah. All you truckers going through something?
Look at Jacob's looking off misty.
Yeah. You remember that Deb used to sit in here. It's all right. Deb's officially my number two golfer. Paige Spearnax, number one.
I'm with you.
God, dude. Hot golfers?
Yeah, that's your thing now?
No.
Paige Spearnax did, didn't she do the body issue with ESPN? And it ain't that great.
Shut your mouth.
Her body's retarded.
Shut your mouth.
Her face looks rough, actually, a little
bit. Man, I'm about to fight you. She's an angel
on earth.
Fight
me then.
She's an angel on earth that consistently hits the three wood.
Stop talking shit. Fight me.
Just
fight me. Oh, man, I really missed that term as like the third sentence in an argument.
Yeah.
Goes, fuck you. I want to do pizza, man. We did tacos yesterday.
No, I want to do spaghetti.
Fight me. Dude, fight me then.
Oh, blast it, Lou.
Take me by the hand, take me somewhere.
Have you ever gotten into a song?
Oh, no, I'm singing right to Jacob.
But I'm with you.
Jacob, we're with you.
Borderline country, I'd call this.
Even if you're leaving us for Florida for a week.
Yeah. You don't care about us. You're going to go to Florida.
Go look at the sharks.
Who? Your mom? You're going to hang out? Oh, dude, you want a heroin pill so you can go stare at your mom's dolls?
She finds you sleeping among them?
I'm going to FaceTime you when I walk past the room so you see. You don't understand what I'm talking about.
Dude,
a life-size little girl doll on the bed that scares the shit out of me.
Oh my god. Annabelle? Like Annabelle?
Fuck a FaceTime. Record it.
Yeah.
And then send it to us so we can all see it. Because FaceTime, only one of us can see
or
it.
Or just do an Insta story from the bonfire.
Yeah.
At XM.
Just trying to get Jacob to figure out how to work Instagram.
Yeah, he's like Vecchione. You just
like
give
me
up with technology.
I don't know how to do an Insta story. No idea. I put posts. I have no idea what an Insta story even leads on.
Vecchione
makes sense to me.
Now, one of my biggest accomplishments in the God, she's so beautiful.
She is, but I found her. She's a little like,
better watch out.
Mannish in the face.
Shut up.
No.
It's a strong jaw.
Fight me.
Fuck you. Fight me. By the way, you know who's hotter than Paige?
Is that her right there?
Yeah.
Go back to her. Yeah, her face is a little fucking goofball.
Yeah, I like that.
I'd say Deb's prettier.
Agreed.
Yeah.
Now, Team Paige, dogs.
Well, good. You could have her, dude.
Cool.
You guys can fucking smash skulls like Rams.
Oh, dude, I would love that. I'd love another big-headed bitch just to smash into. Just
hear the rock. Just hear that horn break.
Ah, Dan Soder has found a mate. Finally, a woman with a neck powerful enough to absorb his hit. Paige Spearnax.
You guys use crunk. It's a cold damn night.
Only thing hotter than Paige Spearnax, her fiance. Dude is handsome. It's one of those things when you find him, you go, yeah, you stay with him. Because every other girl that you find that's hot on Instagram, when eventually you get to her boyfriend, you're like, this guy? This guy's got her? And Paige Spearnax, you're like, oh, yeah, no, good for her.
Oh, wow.
Good for
Paige. Yeah.
Christine.
Christine just goes, oh, wow.
He's so
handsome. Yeah, I know. You're almost, when I saw that, I was like this, good for that guy. Good for those two for fucking on equal planes.
And she's so hot, and that's why they're together, and we're together.
Does that mean I'm alone? Why am I alone?
And Dan's alone.
Do I have to go find a female ram?
He's got to somehow take out these handsome guys so he can get these big-headed hot chicks.
I'm looking for big-headed hot chicks. I'm a headhunter.
Lou, new drop idea, though. You have to have a drop that starts right at, it's a cold damn night, anytime something emotional is happening.
Good call.
In the studio.
Yeah, that's
That'd be a funny thing to hear pop it. It's a cold damn night.
You know what I like about this show is, I told this to Vecchione, because Vecchione, I think...
I don't like having a screen where I can see what Christine's texting out. What are you writing so handsome for? No one told you to write that. You're
Stop
thinking,
it.
You're doing op-ed now.
Jay,
yeah,
this
yeah.
is what happened when I used to face the TV. We had the switch.
That is
Jay, look at me. Mm-hmm. Christine's going to type what she's going to type.
If we can go back in time right now, she'd go, it doesn't matter. No one's as handsome as you. It's a cold damn night.
Vecchione got a little, I think I found out he got a little jealous when I went and hung out with you on Sunday.
Did he?
Because Sunday nights are our nights.
I hate it. I hate that happens.
I stay at home.
Should have come.
We ordered pizza. I know. I invited him.
I didn't invite him. Was it that vibe you got?
No. It was that he didn't want to leave the house.
He didn't want to leave the
house. He's my common law husband.
Okay.
So, we got to go. You got to talk to the mans
So like the Amish, he set you free to live amongst me for a little bit.
Yeah.
He knew you'd want to come home quick.
I had a Jay Rumspring. I had a Sunday night Jay Rumspring. But what's funny is that it's like we don't hang out as much as we used to before we did the radio show,
right?
Because our hanging out is basically this mixed in with me coming over before the show, or sometimes Sunday nights like that. But it's funny because you know me better now because of the show.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was coming into the studio today, I was like, man, I'm in a shitty mood. Just fucking be cool. And I kind of came in, almost tripped up over that chair, and it was just like, it was that shit where I was like, I was just fucking coming in with shitty energy, and immediately you're like, hey, you okay, dude? And I'm like, no, I had a shitty date. And it's just funny because you immediately knew it. You came in and I was like, I'm just going to be cool. It was kind of like the time you and Christine got into the fight when we were doing the pre-record. And I'm like, are you guys all right? And you're like, yeah, no, it's fine. It's not a fight. Christine's just an idiot. And you're like, oh, no, you're definitely upset. But it's just funny we could tell that now when I came in and you're like that. And it was like, yeah, it was just a shitty date. And sometimes when you have a shitty date, I mean, we're not all heroin junkies like Jacob who can just bounce back off it. Some of us.
Lou, how are you not playing It's a Cold Damn Night? So, right
I know.
Picking my spots, guys.
It's a cold
I'm just saying,
damn
Jay.
Damn night.
All I'm saying is, Jay. I got greedy. I was going to say, you get me before more than they get me.
I love it.
And how dare you say Paige Spearneck has a big head?
She does have a big old head. I hate that. Well, here's the good news. I'm infiltrating your guys' Sunday hang at your house in a couple.
Fucking A, right?
In a week from this Sunday.
Yeah, you come get some Astoria cooking.
Absolutely.
We can do BZ Grill. Oh, it's so good.
That's Mediterranean.
It's so good.
Keep it.
Okay.
I'm thinking the King or the other place you said.
Michelangelo's Pizza.
That's fine.
Oh, Grandma Slices and Sandwich King.
Oh, yeah.
That's sandwich fine. And pizza?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Do a sandwich pizza party?
Yeah.
Astoria Greek
Christine.
Food.
Oh, Christine finally pulled herself away from handsome guys and started flicking bean to this idea.
BZ Grill, though, is what's up as far as Greek food goes. Stavros. I go there with Stavros just to have him order in Greek because they treat us better.
Is that what you want?
It's just Astoria Greek food sounds so good.
It's so good.
Go get it and hang out with
your
friends.
Another time.
And I'll hang out with my friend,
friends.
Mike Vecchione.
Oh, yeah. Listen, I'm down with all this. I'll just be a real food slut. I'll have BZ Grill, Sandwich King, and Michelangelo's Pizza.
Yeah, whatever we don't eat, we fuck.
Oh, yeah. I'll lay down a fucking shower curtain. We'll have Jake over. Jacob's Jake on the weekend.
Come on, look at Debidoo and tell me right now she's not hotter than Paige Spearneck facial.
Totally. Should we record an episode on your couch?
I'm totally down to do an old school Under the Bridge episode. That's the name of our podcast.
All right, well, you know what?
Paige Spearneck. No, I go Paige. Team Paige, man.
She's a little picture-to-picture Debidoo.
You're Debidoo? Well, I know you're Debidoo, Jake.
I think Jay's right. It's a much prettier face.
I think you're both full of shit.
You just think she'll
hear
this.
She is. Fucking murdered husband face. Actually, Deb is very pretty.
She's very, very pretty. Wow, man. She gets out of the building, and all of a sudden, you're just teeing off on her.
No, I miss her.
This is me lashing out. You know what's gross? Yeah, he goes, thank God those two pigs aren't doing the show in here anymore. Deb and Ben. No, look at it. Wait, go down. Down. And all the way to the left. Oh, my God. Not there. Jesus H.
That's as far
down
left
one.
As you can go.
Down one.
There. Oh, thank you. Yeah. Hot.
Really hot.
Not as
looks
hot.
Like she's yelling
hot.
At you.
Not that hot.
Where's Paige?
Bring amazing hot.
Bring
Kelly Clarkson.
Not her. Yeah, I mean, as far as hot golfers go, I'll be Team Paige all day. And her handsome husband.
You want to
both
them?
No, I mean, they're just good for them. It's a real good for them.
Would you rather fuck Deb or fuck Paige Spearneck and her husband has to watch?
He's too attractive.
But he has to watch with his shirt off.
He's too attractive. That would fuck me
and
up,
you have
Deb.
To be butt naked.
Deb, no way. I can't
with
wear
socks
my t-shirt. I can't wear my sex shirt.
No.
My t-shirt?
Socks.
My sex tank?
I'm sex tank all day.
Hey, wait, you mean socks too? I mean, look at Paige Spearneck. Get that fuck
do you take
out
off your socks when you fuck?
Yeah.
Every time?
Not all the time. I'm feeling real nasty out of these mugs. But I don't want to slip.
I think I
have hardwood floors. I'll kill myself.
I think I almost, that's a great picture. I think I almost never take my socks off.
You have socks on permanently?
Socks and tank, buddy.
Japanese businessman sex?
Yeah.
You really?
Oh yeah. Dressing room fuck.
Yeah. You really have 1950s like guy who's just like, let me take my suit off. I leave this on. This is my casual.
I leave the suspenders. That's not her.
I don't care who that is.
I wear the garters around the calf to keep your socks up.
You go, that's right, baby. Now let me light the cigar before I enter you.
My socks don't have elastic.
Ah, my joy is going to be finishing. Your joy is going to be the fact that you're here. Well, that's almost like one of the things we want to talk about is age.
What is Jacob creepily staring at?
What are you looking at, Jacob?
I don't know. He gets the squinty eyes. I get to worry him.
Can't see.
Are you looking up new dealers for your opiate addiction?
Jay apparently doesn't want to help.
No, he doesn't. I'm mad that he gave you one. Look what he did. He turned you out.
No, he's fine.
No, he's not. He doesn't shave. His jaw's going crazy all the time.
Jacob, I'll give you a little nip. You want a little nip?
No, don't. God damn it. We're going to start crushing it up in his food like
a
dog.
You want a little nip? You want to wean off a little bit? But you shouldn't just stop all at once. You should probably wean yourself off.
Why even wean? I say go full go.
He's right. Dude. Go full go. I say up the dosage, man. If that's what a half a pill did, what do you think a whole pill would do?
Please don't. Put Jacob, look at me. Get off it. You're healthy off it.
Listen, Jacob, your addiction has reached out to me in the following ways. If you continue and don't accept this help that is being offered to you today, you will no longer... Oh, God.
It's okay, Jacob.
You'll
get
never...
out. Get out, buddy.
You can't stay in my house anymore, and I'm sorry, but I cannot let you be a father to our child, and...
Jacob, do you mind if I read my letter? Here it is right here. Jacob, ever since you started getting on the pills, I've noticed that your change is different. You come in later to work. You don't like to be at work as much as possible. Also, one of the things that is... Do you remember when we went to Austin and we had so much fun at the boot store? We went to Cisco's and you had such a good time. And I remember when you had Cisco's, your eyes lit up. And then we went and got cowboy hats. You were so happy. I was so happy. Lou was so happy. If you don't stop taking your pills, Jacob, I'm afraid that we can't have any more fun. We had so much fun. Okay, Jay, you can go.
There's one more person who would like to say something.
Today I'm here because I love you and I really want to see you get help, Tiffany. So I can have my sister back. We used to have so many good times together. Some things I couldn't say, but we've always had fun together. Remember when we went to that night maze and then Blue Lobster show? You had to walk out barefooted with scratches all over your head. Well, that was fun.
Yeah.
See, Jacob, you're tearing this family apart.
Remember how fun that was, Jacob, when your feet were all scratched up? And then also when...
Jacob, do you remember when then you came over and then we hung on and then you won and then every money and won and then every money? That was fun.
That was fun.
So, Jacob, stay off the pills.
No, you gotta go, will you accept the help, Jacob?
Will you accept the help, Jacob?
I mean, I will eventually.
No.
No.
You can't accept it eventually. This is only
you. Yeah, I'm fine.
No, you're not.
I'm fine.
Jacob, look at you. You wear that sheepskin hoodie all the time now.
This is only right now. You're cold all the time.
Yeah, Jacob, what's going on, dude? Listen, I get it. Your PBA tour, your PBA career is past you. You're no longer Jacob the Spare Batat.
Jacob 7-9?
Yeah.
I split the women like a 7-9 right in the middle. You get it. This guy gets it.
This guy over here gets it.
That's my favorite.
I'm going to give a Jacob an intervention. Lou, anything would you like to say to Jacob?
Do more.
It's not going to be as good as the first time you did it. You're going to be chasing that high and chasing that high. You better get help now.
See?
We love you.
Well, Lou.
See?
It's funny
Jacob,
you say
did
that.
Jacob, did you see what he added at the end?
It's funny you say that, Lou, because today, and this is rare, we're also able to offer you the same help that we're offering Jacob. Separate places, we can have you guys together, of course, for obvious reasons. You guys enable each other,
yeah.
And, you know, for sexual purposes.
It's pretty obvious that you guys nag each other into hot gay sex.
Jacob, you'll be going to a place called Hope Springs.
No.
Rehab for women.
Lou, I got you going to the ranch, and you are going to find that we have some of the best behavioral counselors. We can do it all.
Or you're going to get hooved across your fucking jaw.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you don't want to come to Milestones and see if there ain't no big fucking problems with you using.
Can we send Jacob? How much would it cost?
You can't do two interventions. Can we get that mine out to his?
Fair. You're functional, dog. Jacob's really on the edge. We can't. We gotta pull Jacob back.
He's staring at an empty computer screen. I'm worried about him.
Oh no, I thought I was watching Justice
How
League.
Funny would it be if we send him to this after one pill?
Yeah. I wanna send him to rehab.
Can we send him
How much does it cost? Can we crowdsource it?
Dude, after he did, I mean, dude, this is like...
This rehab program is like a resort.
I know, yeah. Perfect.
You know what else you can get in there? Broken pussy.
Should we actually reach out to the show intervention and see if we can do a full intervention on Jacob?
I don't think they'd do that, but what we could do is reach out to Milestones Ranch Malibu.
We need him to go. And therapy and all that shit. And why do you use, Jacob? He goes, it's my neck. Because it always starts off with pain, but the real pain's inside. That neck pain wouldn't be there.
Yeah, that's all psychosomatic.
If you had your wires untangled in your brain.
Jacob.
He's looking at it. He's thinking about it.
Do
you want to go smoke a cigarette and think about it?
That's what
they always do. They always go smoke a cigarette and think about it. You want to go smoke a cigarette and think about it?
Yeah, I do.
So I'd have to take that up to go there.
You'd have to what?
I'd have to take up
No, dude, you've already taken it up. We already see how your eyes dance when we bring up opiates.
No, he's got to take up smoking, he's saying, cigarettes, so he can go outside and have a reason to walk around. He's right.
Yeah,
you don't want to be the loser rehab. Oh,
what a dork.
Yeah, was he drinking orange juice? And what was that? Is that a vape?
Oh, cool. Are you early for the meetings? Nerd.
Nice
nerd
robot alert. Dick. I used to sleep under a bridge.
Yeah, I rip breads. I got cowboy killers over here because I was banging junk in my arm under a highway.
I'm doing Marlboros, hundos.
Yeah, I'm doing the fucking Marlboro Medium 100s. That's a real mark of a trash. I love Marlboro Medium 100s. By the way, shout out to anyone smoking Marlboro Medium 100s because those are always my favorite to bum.
Roll them up in your sleeve.
Oh, dude, I'd be like, can I get one? Because they look like Reds and they smoke longer, but they're not as harsh. Mm-hmm. Man, I think about coming back to cigarettes way too much.
Yeah.
5 years in June.
Christine only misses Marlboro Reds.
I love Marlboro Reds.
Really?
I don't even understand that.
That was just what I grew up smoking because that's what my dad smoked. So that
well, that explains your laughing voice. And
yeah. Oh, yeah.
No, that's why you got that OTB voice.
Oh, yeah. No, for sure. Since I was a young kid, I was doing it.
Listen, ponies are different. Some ponies like to run and some ponies like to trot. You got to know if you got to run a river trot or... Hold on. Who's got a lighter?
I got a whoop and Penub to show in the third.
I'm telling you right now. I'm trying to get the trifecta. I do that, I can pay my rent this week, God bless.
I have Millennium Falcon's princess.
I like the host's name horses. She's like fucking word jumble.
I got toast to strudel in the
I got cornucopia fun the show.
Apollo. I got Uptown at the Apollo.
I got Noodles McTootsie coming in second.
I got Tomato Princess running out the pack. And then a little thing called Clyde's Hello. I can do fake fucking. I can do fake horse names.
Stanley's feedback.
I got it. Oh, that's fucking great. I got Mississippi Cricket in the second one.
I got it. Puts the lotion in the basket.
Yeah.
Coming in.
And then Scott Baio in the other one. I named my horse.
Scotty Baio.
Whatever happened to that? Did he come out with anything? We never went back to the allegations.
I think it wasn't enough to push.
Sexual allegations disappearing.
They disappear, but they're never retracted.
Never retracted, but disappear on some guys. Other guys, fucking kneecaps them.
Even if there's not a retraction, even if the person doesn't pull back on their statement, if the media and the public, and I guess legally, feels there's no course of action for a thing, like, there's no vindication at all?
Well, I think
I don't give a fuck if Scott Baio gets vindicated or not. I don't care. Almost anybody in the mix, if they get vindication or not. I mean, Louis kind of like, you know, kind of ate his shit. Like, you know, he took it on the chin for sure.
Well, that's what happens. He smashed and then he got smashed and then went away.
Right. But I'm saying some people, even if they're not going away, they're just like, they're hanging in there, like, weirdly.
Like, who?
You know what I mean, like, there's like,
Franco?
James Franco's hanging in there. I mean, not even weirdly is the wrong word, but like Aziz. It's like,
well, Aziz the article.
About that? We said, we were talking about the red carpet yesterday between me and you and yeah, right there, Ryan Seacrest. Everyone's like weirded out by him and certain people.
What happened with him?
But he just stayed
I don't know
out
what happened
there.
with Ryan Seacrest.
I know what happened.
Yeah.
They said he's banging his like, underwear dick. His underwear covered dick on his
makeup lady's
hands and shit.
Wait, we're like doing it in a funny way? Cause that is pretty funny.
Yeah, dude, totally hilarious. You should do that. You turn on Billions this week, man.
Okay.
Yeah, just pop in there. He goes, dude, I'll tell you what.
It's
the only joke I've ever seen. 100% success rate.
You go, it murders every time. Everyone thinks you're a legend. So wait, he was just banging his dick against her hand?
And pushing her head towards his lap every time she would like fix his shoes.
That's crazy.
He'd get in his underwear and like 10 different times in his underwear, he would hug her from behind and like play little baby games.
I'd hate to find out. It's what bums me out about that. That's all creepy shit, by the way.
Yeah.
But what is her reaction to it? Like, is he possibly under the impression? I'm not sticking up for Ryan Seacrest, but I'm saying, is he under the impression that?
What comes back
I don't
to,
know, man. There's
comes
like,
back to the NFL Network girl.
There's like,
remember the NFL Network stylist that for like 8 years, like all those, remember they jerked off in front of her?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. No, they jerked off her, but it's a different thing. Like, I don't know if this is true or if it's ever happened, but I mean, like, I think if I had some weird, like, boner in like basketball shorts and like Christine and like depending on who friends was like hanging out in like the living room, I guess he'd walk it out and be like, oh, sorry, ladies. What's up?
Yeah.
But it's like knowing the vibe of who it is. So my point is being, I wonder if someone's selling a vibe that's different. And then when these things get done, it's like, oh, I could jump out here now and be like, oh, cause these things have happened. But it's like generally, is he going like, holy shit, man, we used to cackle about this.
Yeah.
Stuff.
You're saying, did they turn coat?
And she would do stuff like, you know, like odd stuff
flop,
for me too.
Flop my bowls.
Whatever. Yeah.
It's also a demand for $16 million. So when there's a demand like that on it, it feels a little weird. Like money's just going to make it all better.
She said $16 million and I shut up.
Yeah.
What a piece of shit.
Yeah.
It's that makes a cold damn night.
It makes me think.
I think the problem with a lot of harassment is just the demand for money and the NDAs to start. So it's like to see it like, I'll keep quiet for $16 million. I mean, look, I also understand 16 mil can make you feel a lot better about what happened to you, so it's a little bit of
that's
a
extortion.
Catch there.
That's extortion.
But, yeah.
I'd wear a wire.
If a
girl came after me for money, I'd wear a wire. And then do like remember the negotiator?
Would you meet a guy wearing a
trench coat in a parking garage?
Trench coat, yeah, with some gloves.
And I go, I need the orange juice futures.
I also think a lot of the speaking out is to help protect it from happening to other women.
Sure.
So, you know,
you're not going to stop TV hosts from rubbing their dick on your hand.
But also, that's the thing. That's the thing is, remember everyone said Ryan Seacrest was gay? And you're like, well, he's probably not gay, and he's a man of power, and he's very famous, which means he's got some shit broken in him. Because when you can get that far ahead, and you can do all that shit.
No, I am gay, but you know, HJ's an HJ, man.
He goes, oh, I'm sorry. Cock slaps are funny. Last time I checked.
What do you think I'm trying to do? Fuck her? Yeah.
He goes, I had noodle dick the whole time, honey bunny.
And unfortunately, this is the thing that really bugs
Hardy
me
claimed
out.
That she endured the abuse for years out of concern over being able to provide for her daughter, and that the situation only ended in 2013 when, after reporting Seacrest's action to human resources executives, her employment ended. Okay.
Yeah.
Go
so
get that
right
money.
There, it's like,
go
okay,
get that
so
money.
You tried to do the right thing and you got shut down and
get
fired.
Get that money. I always knew Seacrest was a psycho.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's too squeaky clean.
He's got 11 jobs. Keep yourself out there too much. People are going to start digging.
Yeah,
but he was a heartthrob.
I legitimately looked at Jacob, thought he said that.
Me too. He's a guy, though, where you're like, throw a dart and you're going to come up across his name in entertainment.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So those people are all, like, people who haven't been brought down, I bet have been Just blindly investigated, like, deep. People looking for it.
Oh, yeah.
Like, why not? People are just going, like, oh, it's like, let's find George Clooney. Let's do George Clooney.
It's a gold mine.
George Clooney.
It's like people going gold mine.
They're just asking a zillion questions to everyone George Clooney's ever worked with.
Dude, can you imagine that guy?
A makeup girl, whatever. And I bet they're being flooded. The same reason there's a problem when you go, if anyone has any information on this lost little girl, you know, and you get 100 phone calls of people just going, like, I think I saw her. You know, they're 100 miles away from each other, these people. And it's just either people bullshitting or people just, they don't know, you know? They don't, they just thought they saw somebody and they reported. There's so much bullshit in there.
Do you think there's, I mean, there's gotta be some big ones left, like guys that have actually done some dirt.
That's coming?
Yeah, but those NDAs are probably all out there. Right? It's paying season.
I wonder if
you work for a pervert, get paid in 2018.
I wonder if this will, because again, all those things, like, who is the learn how not to rape video for? How is the, where if women learn how to act in this way video? What are those all for? If nothing else, maybe just being in the conversation constantly.
Yeah.
Just makes a guy. I would absolutely, if I was like, and I've always been very much like, if the girl's like, I don't know if I want to do that, where I'd be like, oh yeah, get out of here. But I think like, in that situation, like today, like, I don't even know if I'm back in a room until a girl's like, well, yeah, I want to fuck or something.
I'll tell you this right now.
Like, why would you go back to the room where you're away from the world?
And you're in a relationship. I'm single. I will not be alone. Like, I have to have, like, clearance codes like it's a fucking bombing. And, you know, even if they're definitely emotional clearance codes. It's the
So
I'm thinking,
you want to fuck? Yes. So, all right, let's go to the room.
More than anything.
It's a cold.
Yeah, we'll get that. When that drop gets good, nice and cut off. It was kind of, I mean, dude, we did the same thing with DJ Khaled.
Yeah, no, it's
all
great.
All I do is win. And when I do get a girl back at the hotel, if she says yes, it's like, oh.
All I do is win, win, win.
Danny crushing Poon!
And they stay there! And they stay there! And they stay there!
Yeah. You gotta learn, you know, our song, we just gotta give Lou one show and then he adapts.
Oh yeah, totally.
He's got radio IQ off the charts like LeBron has basketball IQ.
E and Seacrest are fighting back saying that she basically came to Seacrest and said, I'm gonna threaten to make these false claims unless you pay me $15 million.
Ooh.
So that's what they're saying.
He said, she said.
Wait, who's saying? And she said that?
Seacrest's attorney.
Do you think we could fix this in like a sexually harassing way, like a baby oil wrestling match or like something sexy, like a wet t-shirt contest? He puts up their best versus her.
You know, you have to go through a gauntlet of Kardashian scratches.
Yeah.
So they're saying, that's a rough one too, man. If you ask for money out of the gates, you lose such a huge amount of credibility.
Well, you play your hand.
They're saying that she didn't, it wasn't
the only thing, it's the only
pay
only
me
thing
or else.
Yeah.
It was like, I'm going to make this up about you if you don't give me $15 million.
That's what they're saying.
Lia, lia.
That's fucking gross.
But it also, Seacrest is just a guy, he was a Star 98.7 DJ for a long time in LA before he like blew up with American
Idol. Do you think Carson Daly,
this is Christine, I'm 11 years old, I'd like to request a song. Sorry. 182's All the Small Things. I'm in between classes.
This goes out to my river lover.
I'm gonna go get some river dick right now if anybody needs me. I'll be ripping through a Marlboro Red. Once again, everybody, 15 years old.
And I keep it a soft pack in the pocket of my button-down shirt. And I get each cigarette by flicking the bottom so it shoots out.
Yes, I wear a wrist brace. And what?
Yeah. I'm also union.
It seems like Seacrest is a guy where it's like, it's either going to pour out that he's a creep.
Yep.
Or maybe this chick's making some. I mean, he's worked in women-centric entertainment for a long time. Like, he created the Kardashians.
With his dick?
Yeah. Harassing them.
Like, the Kardashians exist because of Ryan Seacrest.
Is that true?
Well, they exist because of the
parents. I mean, Kris Jenner, too. But, I mean, like, Ryan Seacrest was the one that really, like, you know, molded that into what it is.
That was the best capitalization off a sex tape ever.
Ever.
Paris Hilton
will be like that
gone.
Again.
Yeah, Paris Hilton's almost off the map.
Paris Hilton's like, I'm willing to do nastier stuff. Like, shut up, Paris!
Like, nobody cares,
see me
Paris.
You want to see me getting the anal?
She goes, I can do a dog.
You want to see some real, like, foreign level, like, crazy bestiality shit?
I could go, like, illegal Thailand shit.
You guys want to watch me poop?
They go, Paris, it's done.
But I'm pooping now, look.
But I'm pooping.
We don't want to look. Are they about to do nudity and Fuglesang show? Why are they blocking us?
That'd be great. They don't want to look at us. Should we take our first break and come back?
Dan, why do you want to have a romantic moment together? It's a day. He's already in it.
When we come back, we're getting to dreams. It's a perfect song.
I don't know where you are.
Because you had a dream you won the Super Bowl. Or you were playing in the Super Bowl.
I never even got to the Super Bowl, but I'll tell you what. We were going to win. I knew we were going to win.
Oh, yeah? You felt it?
Oh, yeah.
We'll see why Jay's so confident in his dreams when we come back. It's the Lost Tapes.
Bonfire.
Looking for a place. Looking for a girl. And then I nearly hit my girl. Back out.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Did I nail it? I just went through so many emotions waiting for you to get your headphones plugged in.
What were they?
I definitely would have, like, if I were a musician, would be a bass player. There's no doubt in my mind.
Why?
It's just the perfect amount of movement. I'm tall and long. It's like kind of my personality. I'm a real...
What were all your emotions you felt?
No, I was just going through it. Like, could I be a bass player? And I was like,
oh,
I don't know.
I thought you were saying about me, like...
Oh.
You're like, why didn't... Why were the headphones already plugged in?
No, I was zoning out. Yeah. Hey, what's up, everybody? I feel like...
You're a bass player. Tall, lanky. That's bass player.
But here's my thought. Do I have too much ego? Because maybe, you know, do I go the Les Claypool route and just start slapping it out front?
Well, here's your problem, buddy. And we're going to have to get over this at some point, is that you could be a star bass player.
Flea?
If you play the bass and you sing a little, or you got to be flamboyant. You're not flamboyant.
I'm not flamboyant.
So then you'd have to sing.
I don't like to sing.
There becomes your problem.
Damn.
That's why the bass is not your instrument. If you want to shine, no.
Music talk.
The late, great David Z, who was in ZO2 and Trans-Siberian Orchestra and Adrenaline Mob, that's who I was on Z-Rock with, passed away. He was, he got kicked out of Joan Jett's band for being too flash.
Really?
Yeah. And I say that's a better story than working with Joan Jett currently.
I don't know. I bet she does some great numbers. She still...
No, I'm saying getting booted out of Joan Jett's a better story than, like, I toured with Joan Jett and without incident.
Yeah, she's lovely. We talk every Christmas.
Yeah. It's a better story than she booted you off because you were being too awesome.
Yeah, when you're in the... If you're a rock star, you want to have the legend kicking you off the tour for you being too awesome.
That was very interesting in that documentary I watched. The, what's it called? Hired Gun.
Oh, yeah.
Great documentary.
I watched the first, again, I told you downstairs, I'm having this new thing where I get home at night, and when I usually like to enjoy Netflix or maybe some PlayStation, I'm just falling asleep on my couch like a dad.
Yeah.
I'm just like sitting down and falling asleep.
It's nice, though.
Yeah.
You hit an hour or two there, and then you're like, oh, shit, and you got to get in your room. Then you go to a much more comfortable place.
And I've been cracking that window. It's been cold at night. Oh, there is nothing better than a cold, open window.
I think it gave me pneumonia last night, but, yeah, I do love it.
Well, I'll keep going forward.
Yeah. Your bed's not my bed. You know where my bed is.
Yeah.
It's on the window.
Yeah.
It's, like, against it.
No, mine's in the middle of the room.
So, yeah. Your beds, yeah, you got space on either side.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Prince Dan's got his own room. Okay, fancy. I didn't realize you have room for something on either side of a bed in a room.
Oh, I have a desk.
Oh, I'm Dan. I live in Astoria.
Well, I don't hear you down there, you simple man.
I'm a thespian now. I'm
an actor. Most of the time, I'm in character. Now I happen to be Daniel, but most of the time, I transcend.
I'm Showtime's Daniel Soder.
I'll tell you what it is, though. Walking by that room I used to live in for 7 years with no windows, you're always like, it could all come back to this.
Sure.
I'm just always ready to throw.
Always going
to
come crashing down. If Vecchio ever decides to usurp the house.
Oh, man. If he fucking...
Mutiny?
Dude, if he takes a run for my title, I will put you down, Mike Vecchio. I will put you down.
He just knocks on your door one day and goes, today's the day, buddy.
He goes, hey, meet me outside. And, wear some shoes that are tied tight. Is that a threat?
And, you know, Vaseline up.
I've told that story before where he was like, we were telling a story about being scared about a fight It was like me, him, and someone else on our couch. And then he tells the story about him just, someone disrespected his girlfriend and his sister. So he dropped.
Great story.
Yeah. I think we have to have him on to tell that story. He just goes.
Great story.
He just goes back and hauls off and beats the shit out of him. And you're like, oh, you're just a vigilante, Mike Vecchia?
No, but first he did this move. He got him out and then he got his girlfriend and his sister out of there.
Yeah, he took him home.
He goes, then went back alone.
My favorite part is
alone to go fucking fight a bar. Mike Vecchione, super tough guy because he is all of, I believe, 5'1".
No.
But Mike's like Mike's not.
I mean, he wrestled at Penn State.
He's a stocky guy, and he's like, no, so he has like skill and strength. I'm just saying, like,
but
still,
wrestlers.
Worth it. But, yeah, but three fucking monster dudes would fucking destroy Vecchione or anybody here.
Just the thought of him sitting outside that bar. Waiting, breathing heavy through his nose,
like, with the fogged up glass.
He left the turn signal on, but yeah, that's
he waited for him to come out.
If he tries to usurp me,
can I ask? Do you have the window you have to your bedroom? Is that of a fire escape? Because I still think it's Death Wish outside, so I never open the window.
Wait, you're afraid of the outside?
Fire escape. No, I mean, if you're sleeping, they can just open the window.
Yeah, but do you have cat burglars coming for you? Do you have exotic
it's
jewels?
In my head.
Hey, tell you what.
You could steal.
Craig Gass walked into his apartment on the Upper East Side one day, and there was a guy, as he walks in the door, there was a guy coming in his fire escape window for sure.
That's all right. Well, there you go.
And he was a little ways up. Is a fire escape? I say, I welcome it. Bring it. You want to come in my dojo, buddy? I know where all my shit's at.
Jay's got nunchucks. I
have batted around the idea recently, as my stepfather always has, sleeping with some sort of a weapon, like, very accessible.
Oh, I got a buck knife from that store in Canada.
Do you?
Yeah, I got a Rambo knife right next to my bed.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Just ready to rock.
Fuck it. I mean, yeah, it's ready to go.
You bring a new girl home, she's going
to
wonder why you have a buck knife fucking pinned up next to your bed.
I'll tell her.
Like, trouble comes looking.
Yeah.
I want trouble to know they found it.
If they ever come in here, they got the sack to walk in there, then I got the sack to take one off them. Vecchione's got a baseball bat like a true Italian. He's just got a fucking black Louisville slugger.
Right next
to the door.
To the door.
Yeah, so he'll get you to the door.
Okay. I have nothing, but I've often thought about what I would do.
Dude, my apartment...
I thought maybe a revolver under my pillow.
Oh.
Sawed off.
When I first moved to Queens, we had this like, 50 year old Lithuanian guy living in the basement, and he just didn't speak any, he would go out front and smoke cigarettes, and this is when I still smoked. And one time I tried to have a conversation with him, and he just had that third world, you know, that like, I've seen some shit energy, and I was trying to have like it's a pretty nice summer, huh? And he goes, it's so much nice. And you're like, how long have you lived here?
6 months. Too long.
Yeah, his son, we didn't know this, but his son lived with him downstairs and through the backyard. He was in the basement, but they had access to the backyard, and ours is on the first level. He pushed in the window and got in and broke into our house. But this is when I just had, all I owned was an air mattress, two suitcases of clothes, and I bought a used Xbox 360 off my friend's mom, who like owned a diner and sold it to me for like $100.
Friend's mom had an Xbox 360?
She owns a diner and there's some shady people that go in and out. Anyways.
What kind of garbage is that?
I don't know, but a guy unloaded an Xbox 360 for $100. When my apartment got broken in, my roommates lost laptops, cell phones, all this stuff, and I was on the phone with them and I was like, did they take the Xbox? And they're like, anyways, they got into the back window and I kept asking and finally he's like, no, they didn't take your fucking Xbox. I was like, that's the only thing I worried about. I was genuinely worried.
Is my Xbox okay? Please say did they take my stupid mattress, I hope?
No, I brought it up probably 4 times to the point where he was genuinely annoyed. Where he was like, no, your Xbox here.
Who were those roommates?
Vic and this guy Mark.
Okay. Not the guy that we saw on,
Connection? Not Pete. Not the sexy Pete.
That'd have been great.
Ooh.
They took my sweaters.
Oh, no. They took all my bracelets. All my good wooden bracelets.
We teased before we went to break.
About dreams.
And you brought up my Super Bowl dream, which, it would have been more timely to talk about it towards the Super Bowl. But
you were excited about the Super Bowl.
Very excited about the Super Bowl. And the week between Super Bowl and, the 2 weeks off they have before the game, I had a dream one night that, despite everything that would make sense, my lack of ever playing one game of organized football, my lack of football knowledge, my general overall out of shapedness. Despite all that, it was time, the Eagles, I don't know what happened to Nick Foles.
Yeah.
But they called me up.
They called you.
They dialed it up.
They just hit up Jay Oakerson.
Oakerson's probably ready to go.
They go, who's better at just on his feet than Jay Oakerson?
I accepted it.
Are you a comedian?
I guess I accepted it wholeheartedly because cut scene, you know, it's all flashes.
Yeah.
I'm on.
You're dreaming.
I'm on the Eagles now. And it's Super Bowl night.
Who are you friends with? Who are you closest with in the locker room?
This never even gets like that.
Okay.
In fact, I don't ever see a teammate or interact with a teammate.
You're just walking around and it's alone the whole, you're alone the whole time?
The whole time I'm alone, except for it's Super Bowl night.
Okay.
And I'm at my mom's house in South Jersey, where I guess it has to be somewhat local to the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Because I leave my mom's house as everyone I think in the world that I know is there, piled in the, because even though their son is quarterbacking the Super Bowl, I guess I didn't have tickets for them or any of my family. So,
but they did have a viewing party.
But they were having a viewing party.
Which is very nice.
I left the viewing party, and then the next flash is I'm in a locker room alone.
Okay.
Sitting there, now starting to genuinely panic that, oh, wait, you know, this has been such a wild adventure, a roller coaster of emotions. I haven't taken the time to really realize that I've never quarterbacked before in any kind of organized football, let alone the Super Bowl in the NFL. And I started to really gain an appreciation through this dream of what it's like, the same way when me and Vecchione do a weird boxing thing for some webisode thing we did.
Yeah.
It makes you appreciate what, like, boxing is,
yeah,
how different it is from, like, a street fight and how tiring and whatever. And it made me realize, I go, oh my God, there's gonna be five monsters every time I say, like, that are going to be trying their best to come injure me.
And this
I got terrified. And then I was like, oh, my God, this is impossible. I can't do this. I can't go out there and win a Super Bowl. I can't even play in an organized game, let alone.
Did it feel nightmarish?
Yes. And then a calm.
That was great. God, I love the music. Played perfectly. And then right there, Jay Oakerson knew he could.
Was that amazing? Did that just happen to work out?
Yeah.
Just accident.
Wow. And then a calm moment when I just thought to myself, oh, you know what? I'm just going to dump it out.
Kick it to the flats.
I'm just going to dump it out to the flats every play. We're good to go. We're going to win the Super Bowl. Let's get out there and do it.
Whoa! What a 180.
Walked,
you really saved yourself.
Walked out of that dream car, woke
that
up, and
day,
I was like, oh, that was neat.
The Philadelphia Eagles lost 56-0 to the New England Patriots. Jay Oakerson sacked 17 times.
What I found was weird about it, besides just the, you know, having that dream is weird in general. But
how real did, I mean, did, was it like the thing where you're like, this is...
How real it felt.
Yeah.
I felt like I was emotional in it.
Yeah.
But my...
Did you give a Brian Dawkins speech?
No.
Oh.
But my concern, that'd be great,
that
though.
Is that? You gotta get all your doggone guts up right now! Like, Jay just gave the most motivational speech of all time.
No, it was, I was weirded out by... I think when you remember a dream, not that they're lucid, but I feel like... When you remember a dream, I think it has something to do with the possibility of it, like the as close to reality as possible.
Yeah.
Like, I don't ever recall a dream of mine where I'm flying,
yeah,
or where I'm doing. I don't have any recollection of a dream where I've done something supernatural or crazy over the top. But they're all, the situations sometimes are loopy. But I was actually weirded out that I was like, man, I remember that dream so clear. Like, why was I so accepting of this as just the reality of the world?
But it's a dream because
it's so crazy. It wasn't that I was going. My feeling of the dream you remember is more about, like, we went to the Super Bowl. We were going. We had tickets. Something I thought, somehow that's involved. Not that they were dialing me up to come quarterback. That's weird.
But I've had ones that feel so real that it's the scariest nightmare, and it's not nothing crazy. I think I told you, when I go to my grandma's, I don't smoke weed.
And you're a demon hunter in your dreams.
And I also am Constantine, and I can go between worlds and hunt demons. Usually the second night of not smoking weed, I have very intense dreams that I remember. And that's like the crazy shit. Like, I remember the dream. And there was one where I was, it's like a normal thing. I think I've told this story before on the show. I got into a guy had a gun. I tried to grab it away from him, and somehow it shot him through the stomach,
and it felt fucking real. Like I got, like that I shot someone in the stomach, and then the most of the dream was me panicking, trying to get to my house in order to, like, I was like, I need to talk to somebody. Should I go turn myself in? I didn't know what, cause I didn't stay there. And it was like real panic to the fact where I woke up, I was like, holy shit, thank God that was a dream. Like I was so freaked out that I woke up and I was like, good. It felt fucking terrifyingly real.
I've had the real falling ones where you
the
like,
falling
like,
ones
best,
happened,
best
but
when I'm starting to fall asleep. That's when you're not fully asleep.
Yeah,
and you have that like here it goes.
Do you move ever in your when you're sleeping like lightly? Sometimes an arm will kick for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how do you know? Someone's told you?
No, I feel it. It wakes me up. I'm like, oh shit. Have you ever been woken up by moving?
No, I don't think so.
Am I weird?
Maybe
am I a bad
wrong
person
with you? I've never had in my life a recurring dream. Never had a dream that, like, recurs ever.
Okay.
It's always something different. I'm taken back when it goes, like, deep. I have a weird amount, and by that I mean, like, if one a year.
Yeah.
But a dream where there's, like, an intense thing going on with, like, a getting back together with my first girlfriend, Cheryl.
Cheryl!
Yeah.
Christine earmuffs. Don't listen to this. Take your headphones off.
One true love, Cheryl.
Yeah, my one true love, Cheryl.
Oh, Cheryl.
Yeah, we were in the 50s. We were going to go get a malted from the shops.
Look, Jay.
The shoppy.
She goes, full 50s bush. There you go. It's perfect.
My word, Cheryl. I wouldn't mind taking a run in those trousers, getting in those bloomers.
Oh, you're as woolly as a mammal.
Let me cough through all this hedge, see if I can find what you call a vagina. Yes.
Musky.
Yes. Ooh, I'm sorry, but if my cigarette ash got into your beaver.
So you have a Cheryl dream once a year?
Yeah, if even, but like that, several in my life of just where it's an intense, like we're back, but it's almost like not even we're getting back together. We're getting back together like we just had broke up.
Yeah.
Like it just happened.
Okay.
I'm not seeing fucking 30-something-year-old Cheryl in my dreams.
She's like, hey, Jay, how are you? Hey, oh, you want to get back together? Why not?
Yeah.
I don't care. I'm working at Bingo Hall. Down the thing.
Show me a pecker.
Show me. Go ahead, plug your schmeckle. I'll take a look at it. If I like what I see, maybe
when you
I'll
wake
suck
up,
it a
when you
bit.
Wake up from those dreams, are you like, do you do the Facebook search for her?
Maybe. I don't know.
Because when you wake up,
I'm sure
in
my life,
kind of like,
I think I know she's like, I never seen, or I used to be able to find her on Facebook.
Is this how you tell Christine you're still in love with Cheryl? Is this how it happens on the show?
I need you to wear this and say this.
She used to wear this perfume. I need you to douse yourself in it.
I need you to say this.
It's funny that you're,
and wear this.
Your football dream is you going to the Super Bowl when I've had, the only reoccurring dreams I have is where I'm supposed to play in high school football for my high school, but I'm my age now. So I'm like,
you have to go Billy Madison, your football
team?
Yeah.
And there's part of me that's like, I think, I'm not joking, a majority of that dream is always me being like, am I going to rock them or are they just going to kick the shit out of me? It's going to go one of two ways. Yeah, and then I always wake up before we play.
Oh, that's fucking great.
But I've had that.
Do you dream, you don't dream about like old really or exes or even like anything back
yeah in I've had dreams where exes are in it, and that's what's weird is when you have a dream with an ex, you do want to reach out to them when you wake up. And sometimes if like I won't say which ex, but there's one I've really wanted to sleep with since we broke up, and so you're like, yeah, it's a crazy dream about you. You're just something, you're like,
so you Christine, like, you don't like, you were looking up your I know Dan was asking you something about your you lost your virginity too, your firm
he
was your first boyfriend, and then you came back to him at some point. Like, you don't have dreams about that ever?
I haven't. I've noticed that I...
She can always wake up before I come.
She goes, you know how I tell you I'm pissing? I'm a straight squirter, baby. Those are dreams. Those are wet dreams.
I feel like pot makes me not remember my dreams as much.
I'm very
similar. Like, the last few years... Like, I didn't smoke pot for, like, 10 years, and then I started smoking again, and I feel like I never seem to remember my dreams, but then when I do, they're very jarring. Like, I've had a dream that like Jay cheated on me and woke up and it felt just very like, it felt like I was in it, and you're like mad when you wake up, and I've had to like remove myself just cause like, you wake up upset.
You don't want to be, you want to kill Jay. I mean.
Well, Christine, about your pot addiction.
Oh yeah, I really want to see you get help.
I mean, this is kind of a bummer, but it's true. Sometimes I have dreams with like my dad or my sister's in it, and then I'm talking to them, and that's weird because I can like, I don't remember their voice, but in the dream, like they have a, obviously they have a voice.
Are they talking to you? No, dude, about things that are like, Dad, stop wearing wrestling t-shirts.
They go, we get it. You're holding on to your youth. Move forward.
You're going
to
be 50 wearing a shirt that says Kenny Omega on it.
Hey, don't knock Kenny Omega. Don't knock the cleaner.
I'm sorry.
He goes, please stop wearing that Tatanka shirt. It's offensive.
No one but even knows who Bobby Heenan is, ironically, now.
No, people know about the brain. You
no,
know?
They don't.
Shut up.
I'm telling you, we're out of touch, buddy.
Fight me.
Fight me.
Do you ever have dreams about your mom?
No, that's a weird thing. I used to. I think more than over years. It's weird because we're from a time before cell phone videos and all that. So it's like, I like have not heard my mother's voice in 17 years. And it's a weird thing where you go like, do I remember what my mom sounds like?
The only time I do is when I have dreams, but then you don't even remember it. You just kind of wake up and you're like, wow, fuck. It was right there.
Did you ever see that nightmare video of the guy, the father who got his kid like a bear?
No. Oh, God.
With a recording of his dead mother.
Gee.
Like, saying something to him. And it's just like, it's in front of all of his friends. He gives it to him. And he goes, listen to it. And he just goes, and then just watch this kid go, oh. He's trying not to cry. Bring it up, Christine.
Oh, my God. Great. The kid has a total breakdown.
It's
and
a breakdown.
So...
Like, this isn't a pre. This is a nightmare.
Dude, that reminds...
Or give that to him, like, alone.
You know what's funny about that? There's twice that's happened to me. My high school graduation, my grandma thought it would be nice to write a letter. Like, it was from my dad.
She came dressed as your mom. Like, or your dad.
She's in my dad's body. Oh!
She's unzipping. No, Dad, it's Nana.
Oh, we had to have him fixed, but he was sick.
Oh, yeah, here, watch this. So his mom's voice is talking through this little monkey, and he just melts.
Yeah. Dude.
It makes me cry. I want to cry just watching it. I mean, it's
pussy.
So heartbreaking.
Yeah. Toughen up.
Why?
Then what if the
I get you a mom monkey.
What if the dad comes over, rips the head off, and goes, yeah, that's life now.
I'm going to go, hey, Christine, it's mama. Listen.
There you go.
Do the fucking dishes. For the love of God.
You're just doing stuff specific for your apartment?
Yeah.
You know, hey, if you're going to, like, keep your shoes in the hallway, move them to the one side. It's a main hallway.
I mean, do you need every pair of shoes you wear out all the time?
My mom didn't talk
Boobie
like
doesn't
this.
Want you to do that.
Boobie.
Come on, Boobie.
My mom didn't call me Boobie. Dude, my
she
mom.
She does now. Come on, Boobie. Do it for mom.
That's my grandma.
No.
My mom had this boyfriend named Keith. It was a full-on pothead. Like, dude was like a straight-up pothead.
Sort of a mullet?
No.
Like short, long hair in the back.
No, not a mullet. No, but he was like a real dad cut. This is kind of recent. But he, dude, I remember one time.
Your mom was forking Keith recently?
This was like,
is your mom still active?
No, I don't know. I don't think so. I think so, but on like low-key shit. I think she's like,
what does that mean? Like back room hand jobs
yeah,
and shit?
She's in the back pages.
Back alley beach?
She's a whore. no, I think she does like a dating website. I'm not sure.
Really?
Yeah, dude, she's like 70.
She's getting in just like you. It's these one-offs. Yeah. Why don't you guys look for love together? There's a show.
Trish
There's your
Dan.
Show.
Searching for love.
TND.
I'll interview
love.
The guy. No, hell no. Trish is a nice lady.
But she's a lovely lady.
But Keith would get high. God damn it. Now I forgot why I brought up Keith. Oh, Christmas, his daughters, he had two daughters, and they came over for Christmas. And it was the first Christmas I spent with them. And one of the gifts my mom got me was this collage of me and my sister and me and my dad. And it was like the last present. And so she just opens it up, and it's just Keith and one of his daughters. They're both really nice, but one of them is smoking hot. And it's like smoking hot girl who I have no connection with. So it was the worst. Because it was one of those things where my mom was like, fold it over, and you're like, oh, hey. And I'm doing this thing. Oh, okay. Oh. Look at that. I go, oh, and there's a picture of the show.
Have you had any crying conversation in your life where you try not to cry during it? And when the
Dude,
cry
that was
happens,
the whole thing.
No, you try to talk though, and it goes like super high. Where you're like, you're just like.
No, I,
and I just,
No, that means that's the cry breaking. Yeah, Diapolito?
Diapolito.
Oh, yeah, Diapolito. I usually just try to make noises to avoid
You know, it's like the distraction noises where you're like, aha!
Look, it's happening!
So your answer was you haven't dreamed because of weed, so you don't remember the last time you had dreams?
I feel like I just don't really remember a lot of my dreams. I haven't had recurring dreams. I had a recurring dream when I was a kid, like for years.
Yeah.
Where it was like zoo animals, like a lion, yeah. And I always like liked the
Christine.
Lion. It was so weird.
Jungle booked your dreams?
It happened all the time where it's like there'd be like lions in my house and I had to figure out how to protect myself, and it was always that if I baked them a cake, then we would all be friends. And it was like, I remember almost being in the dream being like, I have to bake a cake. That's how I solve this problem.
That's how you solved all your problems.
Yeah. It really is.
She just throws cake at it. She goes, the lions.
Okay. Hey guys, you want to make a Mickey D's run?
Guys, there's an intruder. I'm going to bake him a cake. The lions were coming to eat you, and if you baked, that's by the way the most dream that we've said so far. That's the most dream shit so far.
I mean, all the time. I would have this dream constantly.
Really?
Up. Yeah.
That lions were coming for you.
And if I baked them a cake, they wouldn't eat me.
This is just insane. I'm trying to tell you a real moment I had here where I was pretty sure if they dialed me up, I could win the Super Bowl. You know, about baking cakes for a stupid batch of lions?
Yeah,
a pride of lions?
I'm a murderer.
Yeah.
You think I want to sit here and listen to this small talk about baking?
Lou, do we even want to hear the darkness that goes on your head at night?
Lou goes, you guys see the kid, right? The kid on the corner of the street.
Pet cemetery.
Yeah. I sleep upside down. Yeah.
But yeah, it's either that, like so obscure or like really real where you wake up and you feel like that thing happened. And that I feel like those are the ones I remember more.
The ex is always the one that you regret because you really do want to contact him.
Yeah.
I always want to contact, like, hey.
I never think to contact him necessarily, but I definitely...
All right, I'm weirder then.
It definitely...
Jay has two exes and one of them's like a part of his family.
Yeah.
Like she's very much like in your life still.
Well, Cheryl's
Cheryl's not, but I mean like to Cheryl, it's like the most would be to like look her up on a Facebook or whatever, but I couldn't like see any other reason. Like,
he talked about Samantha Montevani.
Samantha Montevani, though. She can get it.
Yeah. Samantha Montevani can get it.
She can still get it. We looked her up. She can still get it.
Hot. Very hot.
Hell yeah.
He can deny that shit all he wants.
She looks like a Rock of Love contestant now.
Yeah.
No.
But like, you know, but like a semifinalist.
No.
Yes, Janessa.
Jay, that's such a lie.
No, it's not a lie. I'm telling you, Janessa, don't say that.
No.
Thank you. Hey, you want to hang out sometime?
No.
All right. I mean, we don't have to do anything weird, just like coffee or something.
Like, I honestly didn't know he felt that way.
Oh.
Dude, it's so great that you can have a fucking drop conversation with your high school crush that burned you. Dude, I would love that. If I could get a good Trisha Soto.
No, it's Dan that interrupts.
Hey, shut up.
Hey, you want me to walk away and not fuck you, Janessa?
No.
You want to stay? If you talk in the negatives, you could win this conversation every time.
Flip the script.
Should I put my dick out of your mouth?
No.
All right. Wow, she's really able to say no pretty clearly with a dick in her mouth. That means she has a huge mouth and my dick is really small. She just toothpicks it while she says something. No.
It's to the side of my mouth. I can chubby bunny this all day.
What's up? You want to throw another tusk in there? I'll read a book.
I'll give you an old Frosty Walrus.
I'll read a book on tape.
Big J is going to be at the Comedy Works in Denver, March 8th through 11th. That's today through Saturday. So go get tickets if you're in the Denver area with Kurt Metzger. Kurt Metzger is going to be there, so it's going to be a hell of a show tonight through Saturday at Comedy Works downtown. After that, it's going to be at Zany's in Nashville, Friday, April 6th and Saturday, April 7th. For tickets and other dates, go to bigjcomedy.com.
Dan Soder going to be at Zany's in Nashville Thursday, March 8th through Saturday, March 11th. After that, you go catch him at Helium in Buffalo, New York. Thursday, April 5th through Saturday, April 7th. Get tickets for that and all Dan shows at DanSoder.com. And don't forget, check us out at Moon Tower Comedy Festival. We're coming again.
Yeah, buddy.
This year, it's going to be Friday, April 20th at 7 p.m. at Antone's in Austin, Texas.
We got to get our dusters.
We got to get dusters. I want to bring my spurs.
Yeah, you got to. You got to, mister.
We'll be right back, everybody. It's the Lost Tapes. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It doesn't get better.
It's a good song, and Jay doesn't like it.
It does not get better the more I hear it.
It's good. It's Cranberries on the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder, that's Big J Oakerson, and this is the Lost Tape Streams. Tonight through Saturday, you can see Big J at Comedy Works in downtown Denver. One of the best clubs in the country and one of the best cities in the country.
Let's hope I'm there.
Let's hope I'm there currently.
Let's hope we're there.
And let's hope I'm in, you can see Jay tonight through Saturday in Denver at the Comedy Works with Kurt Metzger. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets.
And Dan Soder is going to be at Zany's Nashville Thursday, March 8th through Saturday, March 11th. After that.
If I can get there.
Weather permitted. After that, you can catch him at Helium in Buffalo, New York, Thursday, April 5th through Saturday, April 7th. Get tickets for that and all Dan shows at DanSoder.com.
I feel silly because I thought we were just going to do this weekend. And I didn't say you're going to be at Zany's April 6th and 7th.
It's okay.
If they go to BigJComedy.com.
Find it off.
I just feel like.
We're talking dreams today. Has anybody, I always had the legend of the wet dream, never ever had one.
I did. I had one wet dream in high school. When Friends was big, I had a wet dream that I had sex with Jennifer Aniston.
You woke up in a puddle of spooge.
Not in a puddle of spooge, but there was spooge coming out my dick on my thigh.
You woke up with like, ugh.
I remember, dude.
Is there a thing?
Maybe I was dry up on my bed in my sleep. I don't know, but I had cum coming out of my dick.
I've definitely woke up with a rager and gone for it right away.
Why did you not hit it? Yeah, oh, I'm going to bone up right now. I want to jump around that fountain. Still give it to generators.
Sometimes I wake up and you're just fucking eye to pecker with your big hard hog and it's a cold damn night.
You gotta give them the love, change gears up if we're going to go emotional.
I rushed it. That's no one's fault but my own. No, I definitely have woke up and masturbated. I've never...
Woken up and masturbating is great because it's almost like scratching an itch. You
like
just wake
right
up and
away.
Like,
sometimes you wake up with the best one you've ever had.
Yeah. Do women wake up masturbating, Christine?
I've never woken up masturbating.
Not woken up masturbating. Woken up and your first thing was like, well, time to rip one out immediately.
Yeah.
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 That's a human thing.
Because of a dream got you there?
Yeah, or you just kind of wake up feeling it.
Yeah, I mean, a dream, though.
Could be like the night before.
A dream can really push you there where you're like, ah, man, I was about to fuck her. Ah, I just got to jerk off to it.
I don't feel like I've had a lot of, like, sex dreams, though.
I don't think I've had a
Is there something you can do to increase sex dreams? Is there, like, a tiger bone? You know how they have, like, tiger pills or, like...
Is anybody able to harness the energy that it would be? Because a wet dream has to be... If you're actually shooting at the end of it.
Yeah. Or dribbling in my case.
Sure. Well, look, it's the amount of pineapple you eat. Is there any video possible? Are somebody able to like hands free?
Hands free cum. Cause that's like,
don't do a woman. You gotta do a guy, unfortunately, because you can't, there's no way to prove it. A woman could go like this.
I just did it.
Yeah. Now.
I did it.
Now again.
I think these people about to walk in the studio have no idea what they're going to sit next to for the next 2 hours.
This looks like
a college radio station coming in. And they're like, we're going to play the coolest
alt
rock.
This is Wilco. With their newest hit.
See if you can, it's always Wilco. Wilco's been a college band for 35 years.
I don't know anything about Wilco. Saw them today on TV on Austin City Limits.
Yeah.
And man, they're old, huh? They've been around for a while.
Been around for a good while.
I don't.
From Chicago? Jeff Tweed, right? Am I right, Lou?
Do you love him, Lou?
Nah, I don't care about Wilco.
Whoa!
I'm so angry.
Aren't they in the Pearl Jam Eddie Vedder family?
Is that because Wilco's not good enough to play the In Memoriam at the Oxer?
Oh.
I don't think
so. Sure that you did.
I can't believe you did. You were in that movie that I liked.
Oh, I remember Jerry Lewis as a young man.
Say goodbye to actors.
Boy, I'm gonna miss you, Martin Landau.
You guys wanna hear something?
Celebrities!
Oh, Martin Landau is dead. Landau sleeping on the ground, gonna live with all the worms now.
He's one of the
Eat worm food.
This is so weird.
Yeah.
What, that picture of just pussy lips?
No, so it's this guy, and you can see as the video goes on.
Yeah, okay.
His dick keeps getting, like, bigger and bigger.
Right.
And he has
this looks like Blue Planet, huh, Jacob?
The sea cucumber knows it's time to do his job.
And over for 6 long minutes, it feasts.
Is it time-lapse photography?
I don't know. He's like squeezing his
stomach. No, it's in real time. The video is 8 minutes. That's why I'm kind of skipping through it a little bit.
Uncircumcised dicks are so yuck.
I mean, it's so...
And then it's like right about here.
No.
He pops.
Yeah. Really? It's like a little... It's like a dribbly pop.
He looks like a dog. It looks like a dog dick.
Christy, is this in your fan favorites or something? Why do you know this one's so inside now?
She goes, who do you guys want to see, Miguel or do you want to see Antoine pop?
Most of the hands-free coming are like...
Wait, hold on. Is he going to do it? Is he going to do it?
Not yet.
You can do it!
It couldn't happen yet, I feel like. There's too much audio left.
Yeah, what's the rest of the audio?
Did you show your hands-free cleanup?
Oh.
Pause it, Christine, and get rid of all that other audio so we could hear this guy.
Get it going. I mean, how do you hands-free come?
He's like, Tina from ninth grade?
Girl at CVS. Now I'm going to call.
Is there audio?
He's just like contracting his pelvic floor.
Is that him going?
Yeah.
Yeah, look, you see?
Oh!
Wow! You guys missed the first little squirt.
No, I didn't. I saw a squirt
up. Good for him.
Yeah.
You want?
There it is.
Hey, Mazel Tov.
That's so weird. Most hands-free coming gives you this.
That is also hands-free, I guess, technically.
Yowzers.
But isn't that a medical situation if you milk the prostate?
Oh, God, it's great to see these people.
It does not look very medical.
Is there a better one that starts at more from another time where if you dildo your own asshole, you'll just come? Is that possible?
Yeah.
What?
Is that possible? Do we try to make that happen? Jacob, stop looking away.
Is that guy in heels?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all wearing heels,
Dan, and I'll tell you what, that's the 8th weirdest thing about them. Oh, look at that.
Send it!
Yeah, send it! Oh, that one fired more. Is that really a thing?
So you got
Dan, if you heard it was the greatest experience, the greatest cum you'll ever have, would you?
I've had a prostate exam and I didn't enjoy it at all.
Me either, but let's say it wasn't that bulky male, and instead...
It wasn't.
Smoking hot chick?
No, but it was an Eastern European woman with no bedside manner.
Oh, man.
She stuck her finger in my ass and she goes, if it hurt, go to proctologist.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't know if it hurt. You were quick.
You're like, it hurt.
It definitely hurt.
Emotionally?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it's amazing. You just come from that.
Isn't that a fun trick?
Now, here's the thing.
Isn't that a fun life hack?
I'll tell you what, though. It's a cheat code. It's a real cheat code if you jerk off while you're getting a dildo in the ass, as this young man lady's doing.
Oh.
That's more what I'm talking about.
Welcome to coming out your dick.
Wow, you know what's hilarious? Almost like it's a button. Every time the dildo goes in this tranny's butt, the dick raises up. It like reacts directly to the to the dildo.
It's like we're all filled with strings that pull the same thing.
Yes, there are strings. Yes.
Life finds... All right,
if you don't have hands, life still has to find a way. Good for these people.
So you've never... We're good.
No, not at all.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Like, no,
I know it's fun, and then after like 5 minutes, you're like, I don't want to watch people just keep getting rammed in the ass and coming.
Christine, if we get super bored, maybe you can dildo my ass until I come hands-free. But I'll tell you what, if I don't come, it's going to be a weird stoppage.
What, are you going to Yelp all those videos?
It's a weird stoppage. After a while, it's like 15 minutes, you go, it just ain't going to happen.
Yeah. It's like you're trying to
tell somebody to take it. When that's referring to taking a dildo out of your ass, like, you know what, Christine, I love you to pieces, but it's just, I don't know if it's your method, if it's the way I'm accepting it, it's not going
to
happen.
You give up by trying to light wet fireworks? You go, this isn't going to go. She goes, Jay, couple more.
Yeah. I mean, at this point, you're just wailing on a guy who's unconscious down there.
There's girls that are into that, but I can't. I don't know. I like don't see the sexiness as a girl putting on a strap on and fucking a guy in the butt.
Pegging.
A girl told me a story in Chicago this weekend of...
Did she have a North Chicago accent talking about pegging a guy in his ass?
No, of a girl who works with her.
You got to meet my friend, Patricia.
Who has a guy who works with them.
Yeah.
That she dated.
Okay.
Her friend dated the guy.
Yeah.
And the guy was super into, like, he carried around a bag of dildos.
What?
Because he loved to get, like, rammed up his ass.
Whoa.
And then...
If I did like that, I think I would wiggle my butt a lot more.
Works with the girl, Dan.
I go like this. Ooh, like an excited dog. Ooh, boy.
All three of them work together?
I only like frontal play.
All three of them work together, and he, like, dirtbagged her. And
no!
And was like, yeah, it's like, well, there was, like, a shitty breakup. I don't know if he started seeing whatever it was.
Started getting pegged by someone else.
It was an ugly breakup. But I'm like, man, to have an ugly breakup with the girl you bring into your world of I also love you to ram dildos up my ass. Like, she's going to tell people,
I mean,
man.
That's like the mob.
Got back to me.
Yeah.
And I'm not in the machine.
Funny thing about the guy. Now in the break room, we put a dildo in the refrigerator with his name on it. It's our way of teasing him. I mean, yeah, if you do some shit like that and you can't go out and be a dickhead.
You can't be a dick unless you're like.
People have too much. They have all this like info on you.
Unless you're ready to be like, I like a dildo.
What if he just lives it though? What if that's what she didn't explain? And she's like,
almost anything people could hang on you.
He cracks jokes in quarterly meetings. He's like, sorry, my butthole hasn't really touched since I was in college. You guys get it. Hey, it's Pegasaurus Rex. What's going on?
You can tell by my spiny back leading down to a nice gaper.
Yeah, you guys mind? Anybody mind if I sit on my donut during this meeting? I took a real boo-foo in last night.
Kick it! Yeah!
I understand you.
You don't understand, goddamn.
That's got to be a thing where I wonder if
you got to be the coolest guy. Or yeah, but
do you think when he breaks up with her, when he's like, "So I just, you know, I don't think it's going to work out." Also,
you're cool, right? About the whole thing.
You're not going to like tell everyone that work.
You already told everybody. I kind of figured that. Even when you weren't mad at me, you told everybody. Oh, cool. Oh, yes, yeah. Of course. I did present you with a pretty odd thing, but I'm saying anything you own. I mean, isn't Jim Norton like living, breathing? Example of that. Anything you own,
yeah, you can't really hurt
that
you.
People will hang on you. Like, first of all, no one cares a fucking, you know, news cycle later.
Yeah.
And fucking it moves. It's so weird. Anything. It's funny to me how many, like masculine, like, you know, tow truck driver-y dudes come up to me and they're like, fucking, yeah, Norton with those trannies, right? And say something like that. And you're just like, it doesn't bother. They're not fans because of it or anything. Yeah. It doesn't change anything.
Yeah, get tugged off. But, I mean... Yeah, if you own it. Most of the time it's the people that don't own it that end up getting trampled by it.
Well, yeah, and you stuck on the I. I mean, that wiener guy.
Yeah, I mean, that guy. Yeesh.
He tried to own it. The problem was it was deeper than that.
Yeah.
You have to own the deepest level of it, and it can't be anything involving children.
Yep.
If you get something where it's like crazy amoral with not two consenting people... Don't own anything. Lie the rest of your life.
Bury it deep down. Murder those
because
who
there
don't.
Really is no. How do you get out of that? You can't own like. Oh, come on. She's 15. Like you can't own that.
I feel like there's got to be some sort of movement. And I'll research this a little bit. If you know whether it's like pedophiles saying that they were born that way and they think that it's right and that people shouldn't judge them for it.
There's the brain tumor defense.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
I mean, there's like a thing where. I mean, there's got to be like. Is there anyone normal that dates like not like a 17-year-old, but like 15's inexcusable. You're just like, you're a child molester.
And he's not fucking her, but just like, even like
like his Elvis, 24 and 14. Terrible.
It's fucking terrible.
What was Charlie Chaplin? Charlie Chaplin was like, in his late 30s and she was like in her early teens. We were like,
hold enough to bleed, hold enough to butcher, rang-a-dang-do.
Oh, you're talking about
rang-a-dang-do, rang-do.
I cut them and split them, I get them out of school. What do they do when they're getting food?
You know, I wear one-piece clothing, it's easier for the kids to figure out. I hang-a-dang, I hang-a-do-dang-do.
You wonder if I have sex in the morning, I'll just tell you, they always get ice cream when we do. Hang-a-dang, ice cream for breakfast.
Oh, looks like my girlfriend's crying. She must be up for her midnight feeding.
Well, since my baby teething, I gotta go fuck. What?
My family went young.
Your family went young?
This was the old country, I was told.
Was the old country Jacksonville?
My great-grandfather married my great-grandmother. He was He was in his 40s and she was 12.
Yeah! Oh. What, Jacob? Yo,
wait,
man.
This is like old, like what's the old country for you?
That was the vaudeville batats.
Yeah, old country was North Middle Jersey.
The old country. Jersey.
Middle East.
Middle East.
Oh, man.
This was before.
40s and her 12?
It was like normal.
Well.
It was like, they were, the girls were.
Was it just when you bled, you were good?
Jesus,
from what I'm
Christine.
Told, he allowed her.
Get that on a t-shirt.
Allowed her to play with dolls.
He what?
He allowed her to play with dolls. Like he was compassionate with.
Oh, what a good dude! Oh, what a good dude! He goes. Sometimes I think you like those dolls more than me.
But my other side of the family.
Emotional great great batat. He goes. Hey, I know you kind of want to play with puppies and those dolls, but I've got some needs too.
Charlie Chaplin was
we're having corn off the cob tonight.
Because of you.
Because of you.
Another family member was 35, married 13.
Jesus, Jacob.
Christ.
What's up with your family? I mean, Jesus, I come from Viking Christ. Blood, but nothing that savage.
They just really want to make more Jewish people as soon as possible.
How old are you? Are you 11? Great. Get over here. You're going to give me a baby.
Fucking. that's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
This is Charlie Chaplin
their,
was 16.
Did the big teeth
and,
come in yet?
He was
did all their big teeth come in?
From what I'm told, it was... It was
wedding pictures with like four teeth. Of like, yay. When I was like a little kitty, like,
I can eat apples again. Have you seen pictures of the girls? Like, did they look?
Do they look like
super
does
young?
It look like
did they look developed?
So like your grandfather's holding a life-size doll, like on your mom's bed.
Were they hot as shit?
So all to go. There's no photographs.
Yeah, well, but I get why there's no photographs.
You know, rage of jealousy. Did a gypsy turn into a life-size doll? Your mom keeps on a bed now.
Is that your great great grandmother?
Is that your great 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 grandmother bride?
There's one. They all look. I've seen pictures of my great grandmother. At that age, though, not with her husband.
And oh, you got to see the bachelorette photos?
She looks shocked. That's always the face.
Really?
Say shocked.
Yeah, because one day she's playing house, and then she's just in it for real.
Like, it also took like an hour to take a photograph, so everybody just looks ridiculous and old.
And you know, kids, you can't hold their attention.
I don't know, Tiffy. The fucking bills are backing up. That's a problem. Just, what are bills?
Yeah.
I like it when I go to the river, and I'm in the river, and it's cold, and then I get out in the grass.
He goes, I just lost my first son to typhoid.
We're having pizza, yay!
I like dough and honey!
He goes, you will soon learn to be my bride.
Bride? We're playing dress up like big girls?
Big girl, I'm a big girl bride!
He goes, yes, whatever. God, you're actually less annoying than my 22-year-old ex-girlfriend. She just said literally every five words.
At their wedding meal, everyone else
chicken
was having
stuff.
She said, yeah, she had dinosaur nuggets.
The chicken nuggets and mac and cheese.
She were of the kids.
And she, yeah. Shevitz.
Milkshake.
They had Jewish wine and fucking Dunkaroos.
That's not even old enough to be a woman in the Jewish religion, Jacob.
12.
13.
Oh,
no,
perfect.
No, it's 12 for...
Fucking perfect. Oh, what were you going to say, Jacob?
No, I was going to end by saying, I do remember my great-grandmother.
You met her?
Yeah, she's only four years older than you.
And,
yeah. Didn't you guys go to high school together?
We've been talking Puerto Rican stats now.
Oh, the batats are getting it in quick and easy.
Had some issues.
They're all born with fat asses.
As an adult.
Just all the batats are born with fat asses.
You don't know.
That's their fault.
Yeah,
that's their and God's fault. What's in that milk? Because all the batats got batak dunks.
Yeah, bataka dunks.
Batata dunks.
Batata dunks. Do you met her multiple times?
Yeah, I remember as a kid. Yeah. Had some issues.
Like what? Crazy?
I mean, now that I think about it, it's kind of understandable.
She had a lot of issues.
She was raped for the first 5 years of her marriage.
She had tons of issues. Prom's coming up. She's raising four kids.
Oh, God. What about all her fucking My Little Pony she had to give away?
Yeah. She's starting to age out of the pigtails your great-great-grandfather still makes her wear.
Yes, I got you a trapper keeper for your second trimester.
I'm 50.
You are 14. Kentucky's child bride bill stalls as group fights to let 13-year-olds wed in the state.
Isn't this coming also from parents who are like, hey, you better let my kid get married? This isn't parents trying to stop people from marrying off their young kids.
No.
It's saying, like, why aren't you letting my 13-year-old get married?
Yeah,
right?
Why can't my 13-year-old get married?
Isn't that the approach of this article?
Did this article got pulled?
I think it may have gotten pulled because that was just a weird thing that popped up.
Well, I guess we're back to wet dreams. It says here you could ejaculate.
Hands-free coming.
No, here we go.
It's bizarre.
What's the fun in that?
Sex dream?
What?
You had a sex dream, though?
Yeah. Like when I'm having sex?
You finished my leg.
Like you dream. You can have a, you have a sex dream.
It's been a while, but yeah, I had a sex dream about an ex-girlfriend, actually. That was the last dream I had.
I think I know what you're saying. I don't know if I ever, in the dream, bury the needle.
Oh, no, I don't bury the needle. I get very close to it, and it's hot. Sometimes, like, she'll reach down, we'll kiss, or she'll, like, reach down my pants. I've gotten a lot of kisses. Gentle stuff, vanilla dance stuff.
Soft back of the neck shit.
But I have had the Jennifer Aniston one. It was I remember exactly. She was on a stool, like a bar stool, and she split her legs in a mini dress, and then I entered her.
She's like, that swimmer. He likes to watch.
And then I woke up, and I went, Rachel, I have cum all over my thigh. And then a monkey lifted off.
Why don't you just, just go.
Yeah. But that was the only sex dream I've ever had. I mean, I've had dreams about, like, exes where you're like,
I don't think I've ever made
fucking that around. Maybe, but I've never had like full on porn. Like, yeah.
Well, because what would your mind be doing in the action of that? I feel like everything in your dream is action. It's never much of you observing.
Yeah,
you're in it somehow. You're doing something, or it's just you. If it's low action, it's just you. Like
hot action,
afraid of something. But there's other people in it. Like, I don't know. Like the act of fucking doesn't have it. There's nothing verbal to it really as much. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
What would you be seeing in your head, like your own back?
That's what I'm saying, is you see it, I always see it.
The close-up face, like, move. It just
their face is close, and then it's like, I know I'm being touched, so you're like, whoa.
It's like a movie Strange Days. I've been here, Dan. I'm waiting for you. It's me, Jennifer Aniston.
I go, hi. Hello.
She's single again, Dan.
I know, I gotta get on it.
Get on it. Would you still?
Yeah.
Would you marry her?
No.
No? Too old?
I mean, yeah, I want kids.
She's too old for you?
I don't know.
She has kids, doesn't she?
No.
None?
Still in the box.
Oh, hell yeah, dude.
It's mint condition.
Adopt a fucking weird African with her or something.
Oh, man.
I want
a kid from Detroit.
Nah, get a Filipino.
Yeah, I would love a
Filipino. You'd be great with a Filipino.
I love Filipino people.
Hell yeah.
We worked in Alaska with them.
Teach them all a bunch of tall shit that he'll never figure out.
Pino pride. Teach them how to swat a basketball.
Yeah.
Cookies off the top of a refrigerator.
You gotta rise up and dominate the court.
I'll teach him how to shave his body hair, even though he's not gonna have any.
He's not gonna have any. This is shaving, son. You'll need this once in a while when you're an adult.
Maybe. If
Maybe.
You're bored one day in the shower.
If you don't want to be a rickshaw driver, you'll do this. You don't want to be a peasant.
Yeah. Did you find the article?
Yeah, this is it. And what's going on is there is a bill to change the age of consent to 18, and there was something up for a vote to keep it at 13, and they kind of like threw that out. And there was some law saying that like if a girl under 16 was pregnant, she could get married, but also if she's under 16 pregnant, there's evidence that a sex crime was committed because she's too young to consent. So it's a little goofy, but it looks like the girl that's leading it is, she was pushed into a marriage at 13.
Looks like nobody could push her.
Yeah. That's a shove. Yikes. That's a shove lady.
Yeah. You had to fucking throw shoulder blade into that one.
She goes, well, I was kind of maneuvered.
Yeah.
She calls her the perpetrator became, and it says,
her husband?
The man she now calls her perpetrator became violent and abusive after they married in 2000, a wedding she was encouraged by her mother, who was married at 13.
Wow. A guy who married a child's unstable?
I don't believe that.
Interesting.
I can't imagine, like, you send your 13-year-old daughter off to get married, and then it's just, like, that dude's responsible to finish raising them.
Yeah, thanks, Gus.
Why? What's the evidence that, you know, I bet there are weird numbers to it, but what's the evidence, really, that a marriage.
Is it knowing that you were in high school when she was born?
No, and we're making more babies going out there to get married.
Well, I think a lot of it's because there's an organization, girlsnotbrides.org. They're kind of like, you know, being a voice all over the world for this happening because a lot of it's arranged marriages. There's,
well,
you know,
that's
kids
different
that
cultures
get in,
and stuff. Yeah. This is Kentucky.
Yes. And they're like, it's 2018 in America. Like, this can't happen.
Yeah.
Well, we follow the teachings of Vishnu.
Yeah.
Down here, we're real big in the eight-armed whatever you have it.
I go by classic Tootsie rules. If I'm brought three bags of grain and an ox, he gets my daughter.
Sure. 12's young, but in the hoo-too culture.
Hoo-too. There he goes.
I have made a great trade. I have gotten a fat, white 13-year-old girl for a sick ox.
You hear that, hoo-too?
I got him. Hook, line, and sinker. My little girl just got us a cow.
Who to?
My mother was very emotionally and physically abusive.
Oh boy. Her mother
and
was.
My father passed away when I was 13 years old.
Flowers
and I had
in the
no
attic,
coping
yo.
Skills to be able to deal, you know, with his passing or the trauma that I had experienced from my mother. And my behavior ended up becoming out of control. And at 14, I was admitted to a behavioral health facility.
This is straight up the out of control teens from Dr. Phil and Maury, yeah. But like real.
Oh, like, no. But that's really great. It's what we should do with them. Because Catch Me Outside girls should have just been forced into marriage.
But you see what I'm saying? Like, you know those girls that are like,
and I want a baby and I don't care. My baby's going to have all this stuff.
This is the other
that's
end of
her.
It.
This is the other end of it. Where it's like, ah, oh, my mother was incredibly abusive.
I should. I got she my baby crazy. A beeper. He had his baby booties that he came home
no,
with.
No, you got to do it from the side of the baby. You go, I had a pager when I was a child. I don't understand the use of that. I had a bunch of FUBU clothes. Never met my father. My mother was very aggressive, physically and emotionally.
It was very odd. I never saw my mother wearing a pair of pants, didn't have a word written across the ass.
My grandmother was yelled out of my life. And Dr. Phil is the only thing that took care of me.
Because I've been feeding her from my breast for over 15 years.
We used to get pulled over very often because you can't put a car seat in the passenger side of a Miata. But she wanted a Miata, so we drove in a Miata.
My mother became an assistant manager of Zubaz, or no, Zoomies. And I was assistant manager because she always brought me to work.
So she did take me in the back where I was forced to make Velcro wallets.
Referred to as my perpetrator.
She says perpetrator, and just from the other room, he goes, oh, come on, Candace.
Darlene, just make dinner and stop with this hemming and hawing.
Why y'all? You call me the perpetrator when you've had a bad day. You know that, and I've known that since you were 13 years old. I know that's a tick of yours.
I'm sorry, Annie says has slow monthly sales this week.
Yeah, I mean, Jesus, I told you retail was going to piss you off.
She's about to say that it was a guy while she was in the mental health facility. Please continue.
He was 29 years old.
Yikes.
And he started grooming me in the facility. Then upon my release, my mother consented to me having a dating relationship with this person. And she would let him come down to where we were living at the time and spend the night with me.
Isn't that the vernacular of pimping, grooming?
Yeah.
Or no, it's with when they abduct kids and shit, right?
Yeah, they groom them.
They get them like prepared to almost go with you and not even realize they're going so voluntarily.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
fucked up shit.
That's a weird, well, someone's got in her head to really tell her like what's going on. It's a shame because like there's no middle ground with it at all.
Yeah.
Like with her thing now, it's like it's got to be taught. And by the way, I'm sure she went through a nightmare, but it's got to be referred to everything exactly. It's like perpetrator. And
yeah, it has to.
Where it's like, the reality is, like, yeah, this shithead and my stupid fucking parents. But, you know, everything's got to be now, like, it's so heavy now. It's like,
yeah.
He stole my childhood. You know, it's just like these morons that fucking.
These guys are fucking assholes. They're monsters. They're
pieces of shit. No,
yeah,
I know what I'm saying, but it's like, because they don't realize what they fucking. What I'm saying is, but you come out of this.
Yeah.
Like, her life being back together, like this chick, it's always going to be just weird.
Oh, yeah, dude. I mean, to glue it back together, there's times where, like, I know we shit on our dads being deadbeats and, like, being raised by single moms. We're so lucky that we didn't get fucked when we were little because we are prime candidates.
Oh, yeah. I was ready for the – I was right for the picking.
All I wanted was someone to like me.
Little fat titties. I was thick.
Oh, I would have let them finish all over my big forehead.
I dressed like a hot girl, too. I was thick, and I wore short shorts and fucking super high knee socks.
Oh, dude. That's – are you kidding me?
I should have been on roller skates eating a big lollipop with a fucking –
I was begging for it in shiny Umbros, just riding up my butt as I'm riding my bike. I used to stand up to pedal.
Oh, my tussie looked juicy for a molester dick.
I was tall,
ready to take it.
I was tall and long, but then I fucked like a ballerina. I bet I would have been turned out.
Yeah, a Nathan.
Yeah.
That's the fucking best.
Damn it. This is why you keep getting molested.
That's from Family Guy. We'll tweet it out at the
Bonfire.
That's
just one of the fucking videos where he pops up again.
Two places in one night. You guys are wild.
So, you guys keeping this party going?
Nathan.
But really, man, you think about it, dude. It's like your bootylicious body, my temperament.
I guess I was molested. I don't know. I'm like 15.
Wow.
I don't know.
You came in with a smile like that where I was like,
well, it's so funny because Jay's like, are you sure you weren't molested? You really have the personality of somebody that was molested.
Say, look, Christina rammed shit up my butt. Keep her mouth shut about it.
Jay's is looking across the table from me with such a look of like, I called this shit.
Later on when Christine wails on my asshole, she's not going to tell anybody. I'm not
when you're just pumping out things like fucking lotion out of a pump.
I still to this day think of myself at 15 as like older than like Isabella. So it's a weird thing to
you weren't
to
molested is the wrong word, but I mean you were definitely like I mean
you were manipulated
raped by every step of the way. You weren't even manipulated, like it's just
I just was so excited somebody was paying me attention, which goes back to like what you were just saying.
But a 20-something year old guy, I'm saying when you're fucking a 20-something year old guy, who are you
saying?
I mean,
a 30-year-old, like I wouldn't have been like, oh no, you're 30, that's too old for me. Like if
but I'm saying, but a 26-year-old guy, it was like, and he was,
and
he was
15,
and it wasn't,
16.
He wasn't like a wretched looking guy who couldn't get laid, right? Like it wasn't like, it wasn't like if a 15-year-old didn't fuck him, he wouldn't fuck anybody.
No, he had a girlfriend and an 8-year-old daughter.
He had an 8-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now I gotta go back and fuck her. You happy?
To set things right. This is why the planet's overheating. Jay has to fuck that 26-year-old woman now?
Ew. Too old. It's not gonna hurt him.
I know. Daddy's fucking, he had an 8-year-old daughter?
Yeah.
What I'm saying is my point just being the guy could get laid, so the fact he's accepting full, not even just like we, I mean, not that anything's better, but if you were just like, I don't know, it's like 15, she comes over and she gives me a hand job, I don't know.
Yeah, yeah, he like preyed on high school girls.
But I'm saying, but like regularly fucking them is such a weird, like,
it's so weird.
Like, you want to fuck a 15-year-old?
No, yeah, well, I really like once or twice, it was like years.
I really couldn't get laid until I started trying to fuck women. Like late 20s, early 30s. When I was in my early 20s. Because when I was in my late teens, I never got laid. Sometimes I'd maybe hook up with a girl, but I had sex maybe. Maybe in my early, like late teens, early 20s, up to like 21, maybe had sex 5 times.
Yeah, I don't. I had, five or six different people.
Five or six different people.
With probably like 5 or 6 different people.
Five or six different people. And then when I started working at KFMA for KFMA Day, tickets on sale
Day.
Right now.
Hey.
Go get tickets now. KFMA.com. I don't even know if it's still a real thing.
Oh, it's still a real thing.
No, KFMA Day is a real thing. I don't know if KFMA.com, they might have changed it to like 92.1 KFMA. I don't know. They changed the calls, the frequency. I'm lost. Anyways, when I started working there, I started working around, like, I'd go to bars because of work events. Mm-hmm. And I was 20. I was 19, 20. Mm-hmm. So it was like 2021 is when I started being like, oh, like meeting women and being like, hey, you're
pretty huge. Danny Soad's coming to clean it up the milk.
But I never cleaned up as much as I could just, I could meet women to get laid, whereas like, there was guys I went to college with that were just nailing everything, and there's like,
right.
This girl and, from Thetis coming over, like, I don't even know how to talk
I
to
saw
her.
A buddy this week, and my buddy, you remember Josh Wade?
Yeah.
I mean, I remember Josh Wade, like, years ago, we told story, we were flyering a fucking mall to get people to come to our show.
Yeah.
And like, Cherry Hill, and like, at the mall, he didn't even, before even performing the show, he just pulled this like smoking hot Asian shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, he was the guy that could put, and that was never my
favorite. Friend Adam, man. My friend Adam growing up, he could hit on women. He was like our age, but he was always good. He was good with girls since like sixth grade. And he'd get laid by like all, he had sex with all those girls.
But not to get too far off the subject though, I'm saying the idea at 26 years old, it's I definitely gross. Knew that fucking a 15-year-old would be like, forget the legality of it. I'm like, what would he be the point?
Dude,
like, that's gonna be like a girl who has no idea. The girls I fucked when I was younger, that were younger, are all my stories of like, I don't like to have my pussy eaten because something weird happened. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
All the weird apprehensions and odd like shit is always, and I'm not talking about like, there's plenty of adult women who don't want you to put shit up their ass.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about just the simplicity of like weird, like, I mean, I've had like young girls and things where it's like, I kind of like, I have to like cover my ears or something when I fuck. I don't have a good example because I'm making that up, but it's like just some weird thing.
I need to hear walls collapsing.
It's got
to
be this kind of music. It's got to be this kind of whatever thing. There's like a thing. It's always younger.
I remember when I was 23, you knew her. My first girlfriend when I moved to New York. I was 23. My girlfriend was 18, and I was like, this is too young.
Yeah.
When I found out she was 18.
Well, she couldn't go to bars, right? So.
Yeah, yeah. Our first date, I found out she was 18 because I waited on her at Dos Caminos and I served her alcohol because I thought she was 21. She looked 21, 22. And then I looked her up on Facebook and saw her birthday and I was at K-Rock and my fucking heart jumped into my throat. I was like,
yes!
No. No, it was more like, fuck, should I do, what should I do? And then we ended up being together for like 2 or 3 years. And she got too old. I was like, get out of here. And then I started circling around the high schools.
Ew,
same age difference of like 17 and 22. Like, so it wasn't 15 and 20, but 17 and 22, and I dated the guy for like 3 years. There like from 17 to 20.
But 17 is some...
But there's something...
Did your mom die by then?
Well, that my mom died like 4 months before my virginity
that bumps
story.
You up. That bumps you up. Dead parent bumps you up 2 years maturity-wise.
17, 22.
By 17, I was like, right, I thought I had to get married.
If Isabella was in that, I wouldn't be happy about it.
No.
Not at all.
Yeah. But if I was 22,
but again, you're also,
happy.
In a weird
way.
It's
very weird seeing 15 as an adult.
There's a very thing, though, about seeing...
15's not an adult.
I'd hope that I'd be open-minded enough to be... 17, 22, I'd probably... wouldn't feel very much. 18 and 22, I think I'd be like, I want to meet the 22. I don't have a choice really anyway, but yeah. The point. But it's like, I'd want to meet the 22-year-old and be like, what do you do? You know what I mean? But I think that doesn't...
I don't know, man.
That doesn't
18,
read as
22
weird.
Isn't as weird.
He didn't introduce me to his mom until I turned 18, because we started dating a couple months before my 18th birthday.
Better known as Nick the Dick.
Oh.
I don't mean 15 as an adult. It's weird being an adult and seeing Jay's daughter and just like seeing what 15
is. I didn't want to bum Isabella out, but I remember when she turned 14, she was like, you're 14. I'm like, that's how old I was when my dad died. Oh, God, you're here with me.
I know. I say, I'm like, oh, mom was dead when I was your age.
It's just weird because you're like,
Isabella's going to be 18 when I die.
Don't say that.
So funny.
This is always going to be known as the episode on Bonfire Wikipedia.
Where you called
the episode where Christine says she got raped.
Molested.
Manipulated.
Groomed.
Ooh.
She had big boobs.
She did not have big boobs.
Check out Big J tonight through Saturday at Downtown Comedy Works in Denver, Colorado, the greatest city in the world. And then he's going to be at Zany's Nashville April 6th and Saturday, April 7th. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com and all his other dates are there. And, you know, just hang out, watch some video.
Danny Sodes, as per usual, hitting the road. Going to be at Zany's in Nashville Thursday, March 8th through Saturday, March 11th. After that, you can catch him at Helium in Buffalo, New York. Such a fun club. And if you go outside, you could smell the sweet smells of General Mills burning off all their cereal. I love that smell.
Is that real?
Oh, yeah. You never been to Buffalo Helium before?
Yeah, I have, but I didn't know that was a real thing.
When you go outside of the club, you can hear them burning off cereal. It smells so great.
What the fuck?
That's going to be April 5th through Saturday, April 7th. Get your tickets for that and all Dan shows at dansoder.com. And remember, everybody, Austin Tejas. Yeah. We're doing the Moonshot Comedy Festival again. We're doing it again this year for the third time. The whole gang's coming. It's going to be a blast. It's Friday, April 20th, 7 p.m. at Antone's in Austin, Texas. This has been a super fun Lost Tapes day.
Fucking A right, bud.
We've really gotten to know each other. We really got to get Christine in therapy.
We got to get Sierra Sky to unblock us, because I have fans and Shane Gillis sending me pictures of Sierra Sky, and she's so hot.
From today, because it was so good.
This?
Yes.
Let me see. Hold it up for me.
Here. Shane Gillis just texted me that.
I can't really see it from here, but it looks like it's good. She's pretty hot, everyone.
Oh, you
good
did?
News.
So,
sweet dreams
world.
And happy thigh cums when you wake up.
Yeah, thigh cum. We'll see you Monday.
Catch you Monday.
Bye.